angry.
Look like an angel.
Walk like an angel.
Talk like an angel. But I got mine. You're the devil in disguise. For as you are, devil in disguise. You fool me with your kisses. You cheated at your scheme. Heaven knows how you lied to me. And not the way you seem.
Yo, what is up, world? Welcome back to another beat making video. I hope you guys enjoyed that intro I made. I kind of just did that for fun for this video because we're going to be doing a New York style trap or drill beat, whatever you want to call it. And I actually live out here in Brooklyn, so hopefully I can pull this off. But if I'm being totally honest with you, really not like the kind of music I listen to, not really my thing. So this might not be the best tutorial. Well, actually, I know it won't be because there are some really good drill beat tutorials out there on YouTube, but if you stick around for this, I thank you in advance, and hopefully you get something out of it. So with that being said, let's just jump into it. The main elements that I think make up a drill beat, other than the lyrical content, is that like delayed snare. So usually on trap music, we put the snare on the 3 and the 7, but in drill, you'll hear that like delayed snare a lot, usually on the 8th beat. So I'll put the metronome on so you have some context, and I'll just play the snare pattern. So as you can hear, like the snare is a little delayed, that second snare, and you hear that all the time in drill music. And I think another element that you hear often in New York style drill is like, if you have like a 4-bar loop, like 2 bars would be really busy and the other 2 bars would be really kind of like quiet or relaxed. And it could vary. It could be the first 2 bars or it could be the second 2 bars, but there's usually like a really busy section and a really like quiet or relaxed section. So that's what I kind of have going on here. I kind of have the first 2 bars are a little busy, and on the 3rd bar, the drums take a huge break. So, before I play the whole thing, let me just go over what else is going on. So we have this chord progression, Omnisphere. The patch is called Play Me Forever. And just a simple chord progression with a little descending lead at the end here. So let me play that for you. So that's that. For the drums, I'm just using the FL Studio stock stuff, just so I know everyone has that. Yeah, these are all FL Studio stock drums. And the hi-hat pattern, really simple, just on every beat, and then a roll towards the end, the kick pattern. Nothing too crazy. And the 808, a little more busy than I'll usually do. I know to some people this really isn't busy at all because they'll be going crazy with the 808s, but this is busy for me, for like my style of music. So here's the break, and then it gets back into it. And as you can hear, there's a lot of saturation and distortion on that preset, and that's in flex. And I also have this pad here in Electro X. This is kind of just giving the song a little more texture, and it's called Distant Passion. And that sounds like this. So you can hear there's like a little gate on it, just giving it a little bounce. And yeah, I think that's about it. So let's give this whole pattern a listen to. Alright, so for this next part of the song, I just added a few things to it. I doubled up the chords and omnisphere. I threw it into a Nexus using the preset FM Piano. Just the same exact chords, just without that little lick at the end. And I also have a gross beat on it, just giving it like a little tape slab effect. And that sounds like this. So the hi-hat is just being played throughout the whole pattern this time. Just tightened it up, put it a little off the grid, you know, stuff you've probably seen before. And the pattern is nothing crazy, just some pitched down rolls and then some pitched, just pitched down notes and one pitched up note. And that sounds like this with the piano. Also added this thing in omnisphere, like this little three note lick here, just to give it some like ear candy. That sounds like this. So if we weren't doing like a drill beat, I probably would have did something like this, like maybe repeated it and then brought this note down to an F or something. Yeah, so that sounds pretty cool, but to keep this like a drill beat, I kind of want one section to be a little more busy than the other, so I'm just going to have it played that one time. And other than that, I just have like a filtered out clap, just using the filter in the envelope tool. None of the drums are actually being processed, like there's no effects on any of these drums. So yeah, and then everything together sounds like this. Let me lower it a bit.